Hi, I'm Iris.
And I'm Emma.
And we're engineering practicum interns this summer at Google Sydney.
Today, we're going to talk about what we've been working on over the summer. We've added heat maps to the Google Maps Android API utility library.
On a map, we use a heat map to visualize a large number of geographical points. Different colors or opacities represent areas with different intensities of points. In general, higher intensities correspond to warmer colors, hence the name.
Heat maps, which are also sometimes called intensity maps, are useful for visualizing large geographical data sets to display overall location trends.
For example, here we use heat maps to illustrate the different types of places around Sydney's CBD. A place is a point of interest that has a location, for example, a restaurant or shop or attraction.
This demo uses the radar search from the Google Places API to obtain search results for a user-inputted keyword and renders the location of the results as a heat map. If the user enters more keywords, the app creates more heat map layers with different colors, allowing the user to visually compare the results.
Find out more about the Places API from the developer documentation. The Heatmaps library is included as part of the Google Maps Android API utility library. Instructions on how to set up the library and where you can view the source code are linked below.
We've used a tile overlay to display the heat map. A tile overlay is a set of images displayed over the map tiles. To do this, we first create a tile provider, which creates tile images client-side. Then, we create a tile overlay with the tile provider and add it to the map.
To start off with, create a new heat map tile provider using the builder. You must provide a collection of lat-longs or weighted lat-longs that represent your input data.
A weighted lat-long can be created from a lat-long and optionally has an intensity value that you can use to weight points. Other options are also configurable at this stage, such as which colors the heat map uses.
The colors are defined using the gradient class. A gradient is created using two arrays, an integer array representing the colors and a float array representing the values that the respective colors represent. These floats are expressed as fractions from 0 to 1 of the maximum intensity value of the heat map.
For example, the default heat map is generated with the values shown. The gradient class uses these and interpolates between them to generate the colors used in the heat map. You can create a heat map with your own custom gradient by providing it to the builder as shown.
Now, use this provider to add a new tile overlay to your map. This is all you need to add a basic heat map to a map.
You can change options such as radius, opacity, and gradient, both at and after creation. You can also change the data set to completely different data or to an updated version.
To do this, call the relevant setX method on the provider, then clear the overlay's tile cache so that it redraws all the tiles with the new option values.
Thank you for watching.
Also, if you'd like to learn more about student opportunities and intern programs at Google, visit the link below.